has some patterns that you can focus on. And this one is written in the key of C. So we start on a C with our left hand thumb. Skip two notes and go to the G. Slide your thumb down to the note that's next to the last one. And then repeat the pattern. Skip two notes, slide your thumb down, skip two notes, but repeat the F this time and cross over back up so that the hand can place the thumb easily back on C and repeat. C, G, slide down A and skip to E, slide down, play F, skip to the C, play the F again and cross over so that you can bring your thumb back. And you can cross with the third or the fourth finger sitting on the G, it doesn't matter. And then place the thumb back where you started. Okay, next, you do that one round only and that's a nice intro. Then the song melody starting at the high E is going to first of all play just a scale, meaning the next note and the next note and the next note. Let's go through that together. The right hand is only playing a scale, so the left hand can focus on thinking from the brain. Back to the F in the left hand. Now my right hand needs to go up. Just my left hand's starting to come up also at that same time. Do that one again. Hold the video and do that one again. Now, when you're ready, let's do two notes in the right hand. Two notes. The next two notes. The next two notes. The next two notes. The next two notes. And one more down, down, down. Finally, after you've passed over the F, remember the F was a pivotal point in the pattern making so far. And so it should be easy to remember after you've surrounded the F in the right hand, it's time to go back up. And that completes that round. So that it sounds like this. Sometimes your hands are matching exactly. My left hand at the end was on a G and my right hand was on a G. That happens a lot in this song that you can notice when it works that way and when it does not. Let's go to another pattern in the right hand. We're going to play E, C, and then the note that you just skipped, play D. Skip a note and play B. Now let's play the note that you just skipped, C and A. Oh wait, I went too far. Let's do that again. E, C, D, B. Now I want you to tuck your thumb under and play C, E, G. And that's a C chord. If you know your chords, that should be helpful at this part. C, E, G. I was holding them down earlier just so you could see. Those are the notes you're going for after you do. Again, back up. E, C, skip a note. Now go into the D and skip a note. Into the C. And with my thumb. Should have been with my thumb. Sorry, again. And then E, G. Up, down, C chord. Say that. Up, down, C chord. I had to tuck under to get to that C chord. Next, when I've hit my high G, I need another G below it. It's an octave down. Now I need the same pattern I was doing here on the C and E, but I'm going to be A, F, up, down, and then F, high C. One more time. After I hit the high G from the C, we're going to do G, A, F, G, E, or say up, down, and then F, C, B, G. Right? And that happens while your left hand is playing. But you get two notes now in the right hand. Before you were always doing hands together, hands together, hands together. Now it's going to be hands together, right hand alone, hands together, right hand alone. Like this. One, two. once more. Hands together. Down, up, down. C chord. High G, low G. A and F. F and F, one in each hand. Matches, and then high C. Then the next, and we're almost finished, I promise. And just learn these one at a time. One more pattern goes like this. It's E. Okay, so it's hold, skip, and walk back. And then hit the C again. Get used to that. E, hold, C, and then walk back up. Hold, and then play C. Now, the next three notes, you were here. Now you're going to be here, are going to be a different pattern. It's going to be walking down and walking back, and then skip. All right, one more time on these three. It's different than when I was here. It's walking down and walking back, and then skip. Okay, back up. First, with these three, it's hold, and then skip, and then walk back. Hold the C. Now we're gonna walking down and walking back, and then the bottom note. Now we're gonna repeat all the way down what we just did. So what we did on the first three, not on the next three, but we are gonna do here. So what was here is now gonna be here, which was, remember, hold, skip, walking back, and then the A, the bottom note. When I move, it's walking down, right? And walking back. And then hold the bottom note. Move to the next three. Hold, skip, walk back up, hold, and then the bottom note. Move again. Now we're going to walk again. Walking down and back. And then land on the bottom note. Now it's time to go back up the piano. So we're going to do the A through F again. Hold, skip, walking back, hold, and finish on the bottom note. And then with these three, one, two, three, and then finish on a high D because you've completed the round. So that's why it just finished different and went to the high D. See what it sounds like when you do your hands together and notice the rhythm. How many, I have to play my hand on the right side in my right hand more often than I'm playing the left hand. So the left hand stays slow. Time my hand never moved in the left. Start from the beginning again of this particular pattern. They start together. Now go to the next note in the left hand. Now the next note in the left hand. Again, but instead of ending on a high D, the way we did, instead of going da 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 da, walking down and back, high D, we're going to end differently. This time we're going to end with on the C. Sorry. Anywhere you want to play C chord. Any C notes. So it sounds like this, the last time you play it.